Well, we're moving from the Benini Sculpture Gardens to Commander Ben. Ben is our theme today, if it seems like it, here on Central Texas Gardener. We have a wonderful young guest here joining us. He's Commander Ben, and this remarkable young man has created a website and undertaken kind of a war against invasive plants, and we're here to celebrate you, Ben. Welcome to the program.
I'm so happy to be here. It's going to be really fun.
Well, tell me how you got started in this war against invasives.
Well, how I really got started was I had a science fair project, I think back when I was 12, so about 2 years ago. And I wanted to really do something that no one else had ever done before. And I have very severe dyslexia, so my dad was reading me the newspaper. And he was reading about these plants that were invading our native ecosystem. And I was thinking, my goodness, these terrible invasives, it's a battle of good versus evil in nature. And so I said, I really want to help the good guys win. So I really started with doing my science fair project on invasive species and the problems that they caused.
Okay, and so what did the science fair project entail?
Well, it entailed what the giant reed was exactly doing to our native ecosystems.
The giant reed, that's a bad one, yeah.
Oh, it is, it is. And the reason I picked that one was I thought it would be an easy one for me to find as my first invasive because it's quite large, being the giant reed.
You could see it from the roadside a mile away.
Yes, sir.
Right. So, you studied that, and what did you find? And
well, I really found that there's certain plants that seem to be closer to the giant reed, and I used the Texas Invasives Database to sort of figure that out.
Okay.
And one of them was English ivy, and different ligustrums and stuff. And I looked at the different removal methods. Now, I didn't know as nearly much about invasives as I do now.
Right.
But back then, a lot of great ones were either controlled burning or hand removals. But the real key with those plants is they're very difficult to remove because of the vegetative root masses called rhizomes, which if you don't get out all of it, it'll come right back.
Right, right. And that's a common concern to area gardeners dealing with weeds. Leave just a fragment of a plant, and sure enough, it's going to come right back.
It comes back with 1,000 of them.
Exactly.
So,
right.
Yes, sir.
So, why does this matter to you, Ben? Why did you feel that urgency about the native plants?
Well, I've always loved our native ecosystem so much. And I really saw that these invasives were just destroying it. You know, we have a web of interdependence where everything counts on each other, and invasives are like a scissor, and they're coming and they're cutting all the different strings in that web, and it's going to come crashing down if we don't stop them. So we really have to work together as an army of 10,000 invasive hunters to stand against invasives. And I really, mainly what I focus on is really educating kids about invasives so that we can really, as the next generation, really focus on taking down these very problematic plants.
You know, I always feel obligated when I'm out in nature hiking somewhere. If I see, for example, like a nandina growing out in the middle of the hill country, I feel obligated to snap it.
I know, you just have to. When I'm out filming invasive different videos that I do on my blog, CommanderBen.com, I always am like, oh my goodness, I just wish I could take all these invasives down when I was there.
So I'm envisioning your army of 10,000 young people out there getting the privet out of
all in Taekwondo uniforms.
Right, that's awesome. So let's talk about how you're spreading the word.
Well, how I mainly spread the word is through my blog and YouTube channel. I also do Twitter and all sorts of different things to really get the word about invasive species out there. I also give talks and go around to the different invasive meets to meet people, be there, and learn about the latest technology in defeating invasives.
Okay, and how successful have you been in terms of recruiting folks to your army?
Well, I'd say I've been extremely successful because every person that we get, mainly what I do is education. So every person who knows that invasives are out there, because a lot of people don't even know that they exist. They just think of, I mean, I was like that way before. All plants were plants. They've just, they're there.
Right, right.
And I never really thought about that there are our native plants, which are really good and standing with us. And then there are these invasive plants that are just destroying everything. And so, yeah, really, every person that's educated about it is one step closer to defeating invasives.
Okay.
And so anytime I educate a person is a great victory.
Okay, so you have this army of folks. What are their weapons? What's the weapon in this war?
Well, our main weapon is social media, which is getting people educated about it, as I was saying. And I guess other weapons are weed pullers and big loppers, saws and all sorts of things to push out those invasives.
Yeah, and you know, and we mentioned the fact that often it's you think you've done a plant in by cutting it to the ground. But it regrows. But the truth is, and this is true in a home garden setting, is if you are persistent about cutting it down, eventually you will triumph, right?
It will run out. It won't be able to pull in enough vitamins and water, and eventually it will just run out and die. But I've heard of a few cases with golden bamboo where the people actually covered the area with concrete where it had been just to keep it away. But
yeah.
That's funny.
Right. Well, golden bamboo is one of the worst of the invasives. Let's talk about some. What are the primary enemies? We've talked about giant reed. Golden bamboo, obviously. You mentioned English ivy.
Nandina, you said.
Yeah, it's a bad one in our area. What else should people be thinking about not planting in their garden, because it's just going to help, you know, take over our native landscape?
Well, there's a bunch of ones, a bunch sort of a core that has really been a problem. One of them is elephant ear that people plant a lot for decoration. Another, and I was actually at Home Depot and I was horrified when I saw all these English ivy pots with the different ones. And I was like, oh my goodness. Mm-hmm. But yeah, English ivy is another one because it grows so fast. But it's great for ground cover and walls, and that's why people buy it.
Right.
But they don't realize that it's going to escape. And when it breaks off, it can regrow. And it's just a real problem. All the ligustrums, doesn't matter, any kind of them, the privets and the
privets,
ligustrums.
Yeah, are especially disgusting.
Yes, those especially disgusting. They are super problematic.
Yeah,
and it's so easy for them to get into areas where they don't belong, because their seeds can wash down in the rain and do all sorts of things and spread like wildfire.
Right.
Tree of Heaven is another really bad one that some people plant. And I believe Chinese tallow tree.
Yeah, right.
And there's
China berries.
Oh, we could be here all day misnaming bad invasives. There's a lot of them.
There's a lot of them. Well, you know, that I think that your enthusiasm for the removal is awesome. Now, what else can people find on your website? What other kind of information do you have available for people?
Well, I have a lot of great resources on my website. Mm-hmm. A big thing, the biggest thing I focus on is invasive species and just educating people about the problems they cause and little fun stories that go along with that. I also really cover many science topics. I partnered with Hot Science Cool Talks, which is actually done at UT. And I have everything from space to all sorts of great topics. Mm-hmm. And only recently have I expanded about talking about my personal journey with dyslexia and doing the same thing I have with invasives to help educate and help people with that as well.
Well, that's awesome. Tell me some of your favorite victory stories. If you're fighting all these wars, you've probably had some victories that made you feel especially proud.
My absolute favorite victory story is my Titanic struggle, I named the post. So it was a really great one. And it was actually, I believe it was ligustrums that had surrounded this beautiful oak tree, and they had all grown up around it and literally had encased it. It was amazing to see how they literally had grown their own trunk around the oak tree.
They get to be sizable trees, and you often find them in colonies underneath the beautiful oaks.
Yes.
Because the birds eat the berries from the ligustrums,
and then they
perch in the
oak. They go to the bathroom.
And they plant the seeds, so to speak.
Said like a pooky gentleman, sir. But yeah, so we cut all around it, and then we came, I believe we went back twice to then yank out what was there. And the oak tree had some scarring, but I think it would make it. I was very happy. That was one of my greatest victories, was saving that guy.
Well, and a magnificent native local oak is something to savor and a great victory to be had. And so what is your next adventure for Commander Ben? I know you work with the Wildflower Center.
There's so many adventures, so many different paths to take, and my biggest adventure is I'll be starting high school. I've been homeschooled all my life, so it should be a really great experience. But yeah, I'd say with Commander Ben, there's so much, so many adventures to take, and so many great things that are going on.
Well, I will say that you give me hope for that the generation that you represent, that we will win some of these environmental wars that are so important to us. So thank you for the work that you're doing, Commander Ben.
My pleasure, sir. Thank you for the work you do, educating so many people about so many great topics.
Well, it's been a genuine pleasure having you here. We wish you every best of luck, and again, I hope that everybody will visit you at commanderben.com. And coming up next, it's our friend Daphne.